Hi guys, welcome to this brand new video. This is a video on getting into Nerf, some of my tips to help you guys become better at Nerf. This was requested by a friend of mine, so I hope you guys find this helpful. So, the first thing you will definitely need when playing Nerf is a Nerf gun. This is the Nerf Triad. As you can see, I only have one Nerf bullet in because I don't know why I don't have more bullets in. I was just being lazy. I just picked it up. So this is the Nerf Triad. It's part of Nerf's elite lineup. This is the Triad EX3. Such an amazing compact gun. It shoots very accurately over great distances. And another thing, when you're in Nerf, you don't need to be able to drop those super amazing headshots all the time. All you need to be able to do is hit a body size target. So if you can hit a person, that's all you need to do to be able to, you know, win a game. Any hit counts in Nerf, so if you're able to do that, that will really greatly increase you. Another thing is that this gun cost less than $10, I think, at Walmart, and these things, you don't need to go out and buy a crazy expensive gun. It's spring powered. It's, you know, pull, shoot. That's all you have to do. It's really simple. And the less there is to your Nerf gun, the less there has to go wrong. So the simpler it is, the less you have to fix it. Now, Nerf does have some of these ball blasters out, and they are really accurate for the price. The balls really hold up very well, and you don't have them breaking as often as these do. Like, the Nerf tips can break right off sometimes. Another thing, so talking about Nerf ammo and bullets, when you start Nerf, you will definitely want to invest in more ammo. Either Nerf brand ammo, you can get off-brand ammo, but it just doesn't always hold up as well or shoot as well as Nerf bullets. Now, Nerf does make different types of bullets, so go out, buy different types of Nerf ammo, branded ammo, and experiment with them. Now, I'm not being paid by Nerf to tell you this. This is just my personal experience with Nerf, and I was requested to make this video by a friend. So, get Nerf bullets if you can. If you don't want to, you don't have to, but I personally just like to use Nerf-branded bullets. Another thing, have that all-around vision during a game. That means always be aware of your situation, be aware of your surroundings, because you don't want to be like snuck up on during a game. You want to be able to control any situation you're in. So that's another thing. And if you get shot, think about the angle that you get shot at. If it's an angle that you weren't thinking of, there's something that you can get called tunnel vision, where you're focused on one thing, and that thing could be like right ahead of, in front of you. And when you're focusing so closely on one objective, it's easier to be surprised and just taken right out of the game really quickly. So be looking left, right, and all that kind of things. Now, when you're playing with a team, there are some things that you'll definitely want to keep in mind. Number one is you do not need to turn your head to talk with somebody. If you're supposed to be watching a door, don't turn your head to talk to one of your friends. Stay focused on that door. You can still talk with them, but you just don't have to turn your head to talk with them. Be within shouting distance of your teammates. Don't try not to get separated. I know it's not really, you know, something that you want to do. There's safety in numbers. You know, you can really overpower people if you stay together. Now, don't feel like you need to go out, like I said before, and get an expensive gun. That is also totally up to you. That's really, you know, what kind of budget you have, because you can go for the cheap guns as this one. It's not, like I said, this is an amazing gun, but it's still considered a cheap Nerf gun because of its price point. But don't let that lower end price point deter you. This is still a great gun. So you can either go for something like that, or you can go to the other end of the spectrum and get one of those higher end guns that in theory really should help you you know, level up your playing style. It should really, you know, hopefully help you as a player. It just depends on your budget. But like I said before, don't be deterred by these little guns. They are still amazing. You don't have to go out and spend a lot. Now, if you are somebody who's about to have like a birthday party, or you have somebody who is, or you have friends that are coming over, and you don't know what to do, if you have a basement or it's dark, let's say it's nighttime and you want to do some night games, here are some ideas for you. You will find this very interesting. One, see if you can get, I'm pretty sure you can buy these cheap like laser machines that shoot lasers everywhere. Those are really cool. But what can take those to the next level is if you go on Amazon, you can buy blacklight light bulbs. So it's like a black light, but you can screw it in, you can take out your normal light bulb and then screw in this blacklight light bulb, and it turns on a black light, which really takes your gameplay up to the next level. It's like, it's almost like laser tag. It's so cool. And then with that, mixed with the lasers that you could always, you already have, that's another really cool thing. And something that my cousin did personally for some of his Nerf games that I went to is he got a fog machine for his birthday. So we turned on that fog machine in the basement of his house, and we let it go for like an hour, and then we turned it off, and it was like there was fog. It really was so cool. It was like, you know, just a different type of gameplay, something I had never done before in my life, and it was really, really cool. So that's some things to think about if you want to, you know, if you're hosting a game or something like that, is you can definitely go that route in Nerf. Like I said before, let me just briefly go back over what we talked about in this last couple minutes. Remember things that you need to do. One, get the gun. Doesn't have to be expensive, but if you want an expensive gun, don't let that stop you. Get the gun. I mean, it's just, it's Nerf. It's fun. You know, keep it fun. That's all that matters, is the fun. Two, definitely have more bullets with you, or always take bullets with you, extra bullets. And don't be concerned about like mixing bullets with other people unless you like a real stickler about your bullets. I mean, you always want to end up with your correct amount of bullets. But if you're really worried about people taking your Nerf bullets, just like get a marker, mark your bullets so people, so they don't get, you know, lost with other people's bullets. So that's another thing. If you're going to be doing multiple teams, you can do up to as many teams as you want. Just take, let's say, for this instance, because I have, just for some reason, a piece of pink duct tape. Slap that onto you so people know you're on the pink team, or the red team, or whatever. So any way to distinguish that you are on a different team, so you don't have any confusion there. So bullets and all of that cool stuff. Now, there's, you could go all tactical in Nerf, but you know, keep it simple, guys. You don't really have to go all that crazy. If you're going to be doing night games, like I was talking before, if it's the kind of gameplay where you'd like, you, I would also say take a flashlight so you can positively identify targets. So that's another thing to do. If you're shooting, for tactical shooting, there's some things that you can do. Set up like a line of solo cups and shoot the cups to increase your accuracy with your gun. Also shoot from different positions, standing, kneeling, prone, to really do those different things in Nerf. And if I've said airsoft at all, I'm sorry, I also play airsoft, and these things will also translate into airsoft, except for one thing: if you are playing airsoft, don't go for a cheaper gun. Go for a more expensive gun, buy once instead of a bunch of times. So that is my airsoft tip, if I have any airsofters out there who watch this video. But otherwise, everything else, for the most part, does apply to airsoft. Let's see. Is there anything I'm forgetting for you guys before I end out this video? I really don't think there is anything that I'm missing. Again, thank you guys for sticking around to the end of this video. You know, like, subscribe, check out my Instagram and my Facebook page. My Facebook page doesn't have a lot. I just started this channel, so I will hopefully be uploading more to my Facebook page from now on, trying to get more consistent with that. But you can also go follow me on Instagram. I think my Instagram link kind of got messed up yesterday, so I will be up, hopefully today, I will update that so you guys can go straight to my page, start, subscribe, follow me, and there, and hopefully I will get my Twitter up. There was something wrong with Twitter yesterday too, so I will try to get my Twitter fixed so you guys can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Thanks, guys. Catch you guys later.